Hello friends, our today's topic is virtual 8086 mode. In that we are going to discuss the introduction to execute 8086 mode. This is very important topic as your exam point of view. So in our last video we have seen the 80386 processor operates in three different modes, namely real mode, protected mode and virtual mode. Now here we are going to discuss about virtual mode. In real mode, as this is all about your 80386 processor, in real mode when your processor enters or power turn on, the processor immediately enters automatically into the real mode by the reset operation. For the real mode, keep it into mind, for the real mode processor to enter into the real mode, reset operation is very important, right? Processor enters into the real mode again. This 80386 processor can switch from the real mode to the protected mode. How it switches from the real mode to protected mode, that we have discussed. How it return back to the real mode, that also we have discussed earlier. Now for the real mode, reset operation is the main part, right? And for the protected mode, the PE, that is protection enable bit of the CR0 register, is set. Means for real mode, reset operation must be there, and processor to enter into the protected mode, PE bit of your CR0 should be set. Then your processor can enter into the 80386 protected mode. Now this processor can switch or can enter from the protected mode to the virtual mode. Now in the virtual mode is the last three main operating mode of 80386. For the virtual mode, when the VM bit of flag register is set, then your 80386 will enter into the virtual mode. Now we have discussed the 32 bit flag registers. Remember the diagram? In that we are having VM bit, that is virtual mode bit or virtual mode flag. When that VM bit is set, then only your processor will enter into the virtual mode. Now why there is a need of this virtual 8086 mode? When your 80386 processor operates into the protected mode, at that time it can support the 8086 applications. Means 8086, this processor is the predecessor of your 80386. As we all know, in the evolution, this 80386 supports all the operations and applications of its predecessors. The predecessors of 80386 are 8086, 8088, 80186, 80286, right? Now, while operating into the protected mode, this 80386 processor supports the application of 8086 processors. 8086 processors, multiple application can run into the protected mode. That is why we called it as virtual 8086 mode. And as it provides the all application of 8086 processor to be executed in protected mode, that we called as virtual 8086 mode. This virtual 8086 mode is also called as VM86 mode. Now For the virtual 8086 mode, VM bit of flag register should be set. Then only it will run into the virtual mode. Now, for 80386 processor, there are two conditions when VM bit is set. VM bit is set, that means processor is in virtual 8086 mode. We'll see. First condition is whether to execute 8086 programs while loading the segment registers. Right? First condition is, as we know, 80386 supports the 8086 operation. It supports all the 8086 operations. That is why we called it as virtual 8086 mode. Now, the second condition is to find the instruction sensitive to IOPL. These are the two conditions checked by the 80386 processor while working in virtual 8086 mode. Now, this is useful in multitasking system. Now, what is multitasking? We have studied it into your third unit. Multitasking means this 80386 processor is able to perform the multiple tasks at the same time. Multiple tasks can run simultaneously. That concept we called as multitasking system. In multitasking system, it is necessary to switch between the 8086 mode to protected mode. Then the processor 80386 can switch back and forth rapidly between the virtual 86 and the protected mode. The processor then enters the V86 mode, means your virtual 8086 mode, from the protected mode in order to execute 8086 program. That means it switches from the protected mode to your V86 mode and again back to the protected mode to the V86 mode. After program execution, the 80386 leaves the V86 mode and switches to the protected mode. Means what? To execute the program, processor enters into the V86 mode. After executing the program, it will leave that V86 mode and switches back to the protected mode. Now, I have shown it here for your convenience only. Remember the steps only. 80386 is in protected mode. First of all, it is in protected mode. Now, it enters into the V86 mode. When it enters, after setting the VM bit of flag register, it will enter to the V86 mode, right? From protected mode. Now, once the processor enters into the V86 mode, it execute 8086 programs. After executing 8086 programs, it will again return back to the protected mode like this. Here I have shown like this, it will return back to the protected mode. Now, means there are three modes. In real mode, we are having reset operation, process 80386, three modes, real, protected and virtual. For real mode, reset operation is there. For protected mode, P bit of CR0 should be set. P bit of CR0, protection enable bit of PR0 should be set. Now for virtual 8086 mode, VM bit of flag register should be set. Remember these three conditions for these three modes of the processor. Now the programs in V86 mode are executed at TL3. That means the least privileged level. We have seen the four level of protection mechanism of 80386. In that PL0, PL1, PL2 and PL3 privilege levels are provided. PL0 is the highest privilege level where all the rights are given to the PL0, and PL3 is the user level, or you can say it is the application level. In that TL3 level, the programs in V86 are executed. Now, moving forward, what are the advantages of V86 mode? Again, this is important topic. Multiple 8086 real mode software applications can execute at one time. What does it mean? Processor is here, 80386. It is in protected mode, right? But when it performs all the application of 8086, then we can say it is your virtual 8086 modes. Now, this processor performs the multiple real mode operations of 80386 at the same time. That we called as multitasking. Now, here you can see the diagram for memory map having two tasks in the V86 mode, task 1 and task 2. Every task is having its own MS-DOS space in the memory. If operating system allows multiple applications to execute, it is usually done through the time slicing. Time slicing, now there is new concept, time slicing, or we can say that time sharing system. The operating system provides the time sharing system or time slicing. Now, what is it exactly? Time slicing is provided for the every process should have right for the execution. For example, as we know, our OS, operating system, allocates a set of amount of time to each task. Means the particular time slot is given to the every process. Suppose there are four process or four tasks are there in the execution, then your operating system will allocate particular time, fixed time slot to the every process. After the timeout of that particular time slot, process has to switch to the next task. Suppose four tasks are there, in operating system will allocate the 1 millisecond of time to each task, right? After each millisecond, a task switch occurs to the next task. In this way, every task will get the execution access. The resources are served to every task by the processor. Therefore, we are using this time slicing or time shared manner. In this manner, all tasks receive a portion of 80386 execution time. Therefore, we can see that at the same time, more than one task can execute. Simultaneously, more tasks can execute with the help of this time slicing system. The virtual 8086 mode could be used to share one 80386 processor with many users by partitioning the memory so that each user has its own DOS partition. Now, in this figure, we can see that every task is having its own DOS partition. This is your memory. In V86 mode, there are two tasks. Every task is having its own MS DOS. The 80386 processor operates in protected mode. It cannot return easily back to the real mode. We know that to enter the processor into the real mode, there should be reset operation. Processor should have reset, right? So, for returning back to the real mode, it needs reset operation. Hence, the virtual mode provides the advantage of running 8086 real mode programs while the processor is in protected mode in multitasking environment. Right? Process, as we know, in short, we can say that the processor, you just keep it into mind, the processor is running into the 80386 processor running into the protected mode. In protected mode, it runs or it performs the 8086 real mode operations or 8086 operations in the multitasking environment. Multiple tasks can execute at the same time in the time shared manner. In this way, 8086 mode is used by 80386 processor. Thank you.